YouTube team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And in no surprise or anything to anybody whatsoever, the Browns have exercised the fifth-year option, not only on Baker Mayfield, but also on Denzel Ward. So both of those guys are going to be getting a significant pay raise next year, not this year, but next year. And this is what the first round, being picked in the first round, allows teams to do. It allows teams to have that fifth year option, so where they can really decide, like, okay, what are we going to do moving forward? And it gives them another year of to just wait and see if they choose to do that. Or the teams, they still have the option to still sign these guys to large contract extensions right here, right now. That's, of course, up to the team. But the fifth-year option, that buys you more time while still being able to retain the rights of whatever certain player it may be. Now, as far as the money, Baker Mayfield, his fifth-year option is going to be worth $18.858 million. So that's a significant amount of money. And Denzel Ward's, his will be worth $13.294 million. So about $13.3 million. Still a significant amount of money. A little bit less than Baker Mayfield, but still. So this gives the Browns time. So they, I would expect to see somebody. I would expect to see Chubb re-signed before this season starts. Because like I said, I know it does buy you more time with those players, but also you got other guys that are due for contract extensions like very soon. But this is a move where, I mean, we knew this was coming. We knew this was coming. There's no way that they let Baker Mayfield go, for sure, because that's their guy now. That's their guy. That's their franchise quarterback right here, right now. And we certainly saw what happens when you truly invest in an offensive line for your quarterback. Because the Browns, ever since Baker Mayfield, they had weapons. Weapons was not an issue for the Browns. They definitely invested in providing weapons for Baker Mayfield. But those weapons, like, they can't be used to the best of their ability if that offensive line is not blocking to the best of their ability. So they went and spent, a first-round draft pick on Jedrick Willis Jr. They get Conklin from, from the Titans, I believe. I may be wrong, though. I'm trying to remember off the top of my head. But regardless, they stepped up the offensive line big time, and that allowed the Browns to do their thing. And they also, while they upgraded the offensive line, they also continue to do what they do, and what helped Baker Mayfield a lot is the run game. It's the run game. So the offensive line, they were able to block better for the run game, and then that helped Baker Mayfield in the play action game. So that just helped their offense take another step forward. Now, if their defense could take another step forward, then maybe things would have been a little bit better. But their defense last year was a big yikes. But I know they're hoping that the addition of Jadeveon Clowney, and hopefully for their sake, he can be a healthy Jadeveon Clowney. That could certainly help the Browns out tremendously. But we'll see how everything goes, and we'll see how everything works itself out. The Browns have certainly created a very stacked roster, but this is something that they do every year. And they is no different this year, but they made a lot of moves, a whole lot of moves. The most significant ones, obviously, Jadeveon Clowney, Troy Hill as the slot corner, and John Johnson, the safety. So those are the significant moves. But then you think about just depth. You think about depth, getting Grant Delpit back. That could serve as a nice, and I don't even want to say bonus, but yeah, it could be a bonus because you played without him last year. So now anything that you get from him this year, especially after adding John Johnson, it'll be like, oh, okay, this is good. I like this. And then you hope that Denzel Ward, he can remain healthy as well. And Greedy, too. Forgot about Greedy. There's Greedy Johnson, too. So, yeah, man, Browns, they're going to get guys back, and they made a lot of additions, too. So we'll see how this roster ends up stacking up. But then now, after all that, you have the draft next week. So you still have even more ways to improve your team. Browns have been getting busy this offseason. They were like, man, we made the playoffs for the first time in forever last year. And it was looking a little shaky toward the end. But they made it. And they won. And they hung right in there with the Chiefs. I know Patrick Mahomes, he did get hurt. But They hung right in there with the Chiefs till the very end, and oh, that the way that they lost, it was just ugh. That is like the most painful kind of losses. Those losses that come down to the very end, and it was on a fourth down play too, with their backup QB. It was on a fourth down play with their backup QB, and again, this is where it came down. Now, if the offense would have put up some more points, then it may have been different. But this is why the Browns needed to make all those moves on defense, because they were like, man, that's where they ended up losing. How do you lose sight of Tyreek Hill? That's Chiefs. That's their guy, Tyreek Hill. And you let him slip. Anyway, this is why they went crazy this offseason, as they always do. But again, the draft allows them to go even crazier. So it's almost like, man, it almost feels like with the Browns, like these dudes, you know how when you play Madden, and I mean, they got to do this in real life too, but you know how when you play Madden and you're getting ready, you go into the offseason and the roster, it starts off at 75 players. That's how many you can add. Oh, that's how many players you can have. But then you start signing this free agent, that guy, that guy, that guy, that guy. And then you may get up to like 65 players or something like that. Then you got a bunch of draft picks too. So then you go through the draft and it's like, oh man, you got to cut some players because you got too many. It seems like the Browns gonna have too many, because they done made like 80 signings and they already had like 80 people on the roster, and now they about to pick 80 draft picks. But they've been moving, so good for them, man. I'm always glad when it's more competition in the AFC North. I love it. I love it. I know some fans will be like, oh no, why would you want these teams to get better in your own division? No. Because if these teams in the division get better, it only benefits the division, straight up. And y'all know me, I'm a Ravens fan. So if the Browns get better, that would challenge the Ravens to, continue taking care of the Browns, because they have been taking care of the Browns for the most part under Baker Mayfield. But that would continue the Ravens to have to step it up against the Browns. Now, Steelers, they swept the Ravens last year. Even with the C-19 game, Steelers still went 2-0 against the Ravens. The Steelers get better, that will challenge the Ravens to still step it up against them. And even with the Bengals too. You know, Bengals gonna get better. Bengals already got like 20 receivers. They probably gonna add about 20 more after the draft. You know how Bengals make sure that they got about 50 receivers on their team. So it challenges the Ravens to step it up that much more too. And then if you're being challenged within your division, if you're really being challenged within your division, it helps you when you step out of your division, because it helps you step up to the plate to those guys too. So I welcome a challenge. I welcome these other AFC North teams to get better, because it just breeds excellence. Team, keep it clean. Y'all are excellent. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And just like Baker Mayfield and Denzel Ward won't be next season, I'm out.